I ask everyone present to please rise and repeat the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In the absence of clergy, I ask all to bow their heads for a moment of silence. The reading of the journal.
In Senate Friday, January 25th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Thursday, January 24th, was read and approved on motion. Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Libous.
Thank you, Madam President. Madam President, I move the following bill be discharged from its respective committee and recommend that we strike the enacting clause, and it would be Senate Print 2307 by Senator Ball.
So ordered. Senator Libous.
Madam President, at this time I will call an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332. Immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332. The Senate should stand at ease.
There will be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332. The Senate will stand at ease. Senator Libous.
Thank you, Madam President. I move to, wait a minute, I'm sorry, let me come back. May we please return to the reports of standing committees? I believe there's a report of the Rules Committee at the desk.
There is a report of the Rules Committee at the desk. The Secretary will read.
Senator Skelton, Committee on Rules, reports the following resolution. Number 314 by Senator Skelton Klein, Senate Resolution amending Section 1 of Rule 8 of the Senate Rules in relation to establishing a standing committee on infrastructure and capital investment.
Senator Libous.
I move to accept the report of the Rules Committee.
All in favor of accepting the report of the Rules Committee signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The report is accepted. Senator Libous.
Madam President, there's a privilege resolution at the desk. May we please have the title read and move for its immediate adoption.
Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution number 314 by Senator Skelton Klein, amending Section 1 of Rule 8 of the Senate Rules in relation to establishing a standing committee on infrastructure and capital investment.
The question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Libous.
Thank you, Madam President. There's another privilege resolution at the desk. May we have the title read and move for its immediate adoption.
Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution by Senator Skelton Klein, providing for a Senate Select Committee on Libraries.
The question is on the resolution. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Senator Farley.
I rise to speak to this resolution because, you know, we're a very partisan group in here, and if there's anything that is nonpartisan in this Senate, it is libraries. When I first came into the Senate 37 years ago, I think before you were even born, Madam President, but anyway, when I first came into the Senate, they said, Professor, you've got libraries. And I've had it ever since, and it's been a labor of love. There was subcommittees and so forth, and in the last session, they created a select committee on libraries. Frankly, it's one of the largest committees in the New York State Senate. And when it was proposed, practically every member from both sides wanted to get on it. And it does meet, and we had a very fine meeting last year that informative. It's called a round table, where we discussed the needs of the libraries and heard from the leaders of this area. And this House was successful in getting in the budget a $3.9 million increase in the aid to libraries. Of course, I think if there's anything that we want to go forward with, that libraries should be considered just like education. If education gets a raise, so should libraries, because they are the cathedrals of learning for the general public. Additionally, we were able to pass almost the entire agenda for the New York State Library Association. You know, New York State is far and away the leader in the nation in libraries. There's no state that even compares to us. We have 750 public libraries, there are 2,000 school libraries, and 265 academic libraries, and 450 special and institution libraries that are chartered in this state. As I said, in New York State, libraries are the cathedrals of learning for the general public, and they help the public access information, and particularly the poor and the elderly and so forth, and they are moving into the high-tech area, and many people use the libraries to further their education, to find jobs, and further their careers. Libraries are an incredible service to the public, and I commend the leadership of this House for recognizing that, and we look forward to a good year for libraries. And I thank my colleagues on both sides of this aisle for their tremendous support of libraries. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator Farley. Senator Serrano on the resolution.
Thank you very much, Madam President. Just wanted to thank Senator Farley for this resolution and the work that he's done on libraries. I had the good fortune of serving on the Select Committee last year. And I think it's so important. Oftentimes, libraries are forgotten. We sort of take them for granted. We think they're always going to be there. We always think they're going to be well-stocked and up-to-date and have all the things that they need to operate, but they oftentimes don't. They get forgotten, and it's important that we, as elected officials, fortify them, make sure that they have the tools that they need to continue being the cathedrals to education, as the senator very aptly put it. So I commend him for the senator for his great work on libraries. I want to work with you on this, and I hope that all of us in both houses really do a lot of work to make sure that they are fortified throughout the state. Thank you.
Are there any other members wishing to speak on the resolution? Seeing none, the question had been put before Senator Farley got up. It was clear the ayes have it. The resolution is adopted. Senator Libous.
Thank you, Madam President. There's another privilege resolution at the desk. Could we have the title read and move for its immediate adoption? I believe you could call on Senator Mazars.
Secretary will read.
Senate resolution by Senators Skelos and Klein providing for a Senate Select Committee on State Native American Relations.
Senator Mazars.
Thank you very much, Madam President. I want to begin by thanking Senator Skelos and Klein for reappointing this committee for another 2 years. The Select Committee on Native American Relations is the only official legislative entity aimed at promoting cooperation between the state of New York and our various Native American nations. Over the last 2 years, I and members of the committee have visited with the Seneca Nation, the Tuscarora Nation, the St. Regis Mohawk Nation, and the Oneida Nation. During the next 2 years, we plan on completing visits to all the other Native American nations. And all too often, I think that news reports tend to pigeonhole, if you will, the interest of Native Americans in maybe one or two specific areas. But really, what we have found is that there are a diversity of issues involving the state in areas where we can work cooperatively with our neighbors and friends in the various Native American communities. Certainly when it comes to economic development, I can tell you, within my district alone, the Seneca Nation is one of the largest employers, not just in my district, but in all of Western New York. They're a great economic development engine up in the North Country, in Senator Little's district, and certainly in Central New York and the Syracuse area. We look forward to the members of this committee look forward to holding additional hearings. We held two hearings already on economic development issues, energy-related issues. I know that we've worked with the Seneca Nation on the Kinzuya Dam project in Western New York, where the Senecas have taken a leading role in providing and getting hydropower that's produced here in the state of New York or with assets of the state of New York to be brought back here to benefit both the state and the Seneca Nation. So it is with the gratitude, Madam President, that I rise in support of the continuation of the good work that we've been doing for 2 years with the START, and I think we will see more successes this year. Thank you very much, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator Mazios. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard on the resolution? Seeing none, the question is on the resolution. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The resolution is adopted. Senator Libous.
Madam President,
from the Assembly, please.
Messages from the Assembly. The Secretary will read.
The Assembly sent for concurrence the following bill. A motion by Senator Skelos and Senator Klein. The rules were suspended and said bill ordered to a third reading. Assembly Bill number 2296.
Bill is ordered direct to third reading. The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 8 by member of the Assembly Abate, Assembly Print 2296, an act to amend the Administrative Code of the City of New York.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco Libous, Klein, Skelos, Stewart, Cousins, Zeldin. Ayes 58.
Bill is passed. Senator Libous.
Madam President, at this time, Senator Skelos hands up the following Republican conference membership in accordance to the rules.
So ordered. Senator Libous.
Thank you.
Madam President, at this time, Senator Klein hands up the following IDC conference membership.
So ordered. Senator Libous.
President, Senator Klein and Senator Skelos hand up the following committee assignments and ask that such assignments be filed in the journal.
So ordered.
Do you have their assignments? Just not even stand at ease, just take a deep breath for a moment. We have some administrative work that is taking place here at the chair, and as soon as that is completed, we'll take the next step.
We will take a deep breath, Senator Libous.
Thank you.
Senator Libous, I've been holding my breath.
You no longer have to hold your breath. That was pretty good, about 25 minutes. I have, in consultation with Senator Stewart Cousins, Senator Klein, Senator Skelos, hand up the following minority committee assignments and ask that said assignments be filed in the journal, please.
So ordered, Senator Libous.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
Thank you, Madam President. There being no further business, I move that we adjourn until Tuesday, January 29th at 11 a.m.
There being no further business, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, January 29th at 11 a.m.